Hey Capricorn, it's me G1 Writer with G1 Insights, your favorite tarot reader. Okay, I'm doing your life and love energy for the month of July 2019. Happy summer. Excuse me guys, I have a cough drop in my mouth. It's been real, okay? These allergies are killing me. So, I don't want to take up too much of your time, but I had to talk to you Capricorn because, okay, we have a lot of different energy flowing around this season and it's going to be real, okay? Make sure you guys comment below, like and share, and subscribe to my channel, please. Thank you. Love you. All right? So, Capricorn, listen. July 2nd is the new moon. I'm jumping ahead. Sorry. July 2nd is the new moon in Cancer. Of course, that is great for creativity, nurturing yourself, nurturing your home and your children, nurturing your family and your loved ones. This is going to be a really great week to really kind of just woosah, to relax, you know, go to the beach, go outdoors, enjoy yourself, okay? I feel like a lot of you have been indoors way too long and you really need to just go. Just go. Just go for it. Have fun. Relax. Because you work way too hard. Okay? And lately, I feel like in the month of May and June, it was really all about gaining some perspectives and really trying to clear your head. But you still had a lot on your mind and a lot on your heart when it came to finances and family and your personal life. You had a lot on your plate, right? So this is like the kickoff season in July. It's kickoff season. That means it's time for you to go for it. It's an action season, literally. Okay? Capricorn, I feel like a lot of you want great healing and happiness and love, and lately it hasn't been that way. Try to wear a lot of yellow this season, okay? Try to wear a lot of yellow or a lot of blues to represent your communication. You know, try to wear a lot of yellows or like kind of like a brownish or, nah, not brown. Just stick to the yellow. It'll make you happy. Okay, but whatever it is, I feel like somebody may try to throw you off course a little bit during the season, and not in a bad way, but I feel like the intentions are good, but they're just crazy, okay? I feel like a lot of you Capricorns want to strictly budget, because you want healing and happiness, and I feel like a lot of moments this season is going to be like, oh my God, and I'm going to tell you why, because Mercury's going to go retrograde July 7th to July 31st, okay? The good thing that you have in your favor, Capricorn, is that Mercury retrograde is not happening in your sister sign this year. So, that is really amazing. That means you can breathe. You can be happy. There's no delays. There's no headaches, okay? It's going to start off in your opposite. Uh-oh, my peppermint just fell out of my mouth. Sorry. Oh, well. It's probably dirty now. So, sorry about that. So, Mercury is going to go retrograde in your opposite sign, Cancer, okay? Which is good in a way, but the only problem with that is because you guys are going to be thinking a lot about the past. And some moments may make you feel like, nope, I'm not doing this again. I'm budgeting my money. I'm saving my money. You can do what you want to do, but this is what I'm going to do. And I feel like you have to kind of set some boundaries, and not to be mean about it, but you guys have to set some boundaries just because you may have a plan in place. And, of course, with Mercury retrograde, things can be delayed, things can be canceled. But what I love about you, Capricorn, is that I always tell you, you are the master of what? Manifestation. I always tell you that. Because if it's anybody that fall and that know how to get right back up, it is definitely you. So even when there is a minor setback, not nothing too drastic, you won't go into a deep depression or anything, right? But even if it's just a minor setback, you tend to get annoyed because you like things to be in place. You like things to be settled in place. You don't want to have to worry about things, right? So I feel like you're being extra serious this season when it comes to your finances, when it comes to your home life. You're kind of holding on really, really tight. You're holding on really, really, really tight to something. And I got a good feeling that it is your finances. You're going to be tremendously blessed with something. And that value, I don't know, it's something that means a lot to you, Capricorn. And a lot of zodiac signs are actually doing that this season where they're like, nope. And I think it's because Cancer, just like Capricorn, you know, they like stability. They like that home front. They like to feel loved and relaxed. And so even you will have a full moon in your sign, July 15th or 16th, give or take a day. And that is really going to open up your eyes to see, like, you know what? I have to be more cautious about how I'm spending my money and how I'm dealing with people and where I'm going and how I'm, what I'm investing in. Like, I just feel like you're paying very close attention to your finances this season. And that's really, really good. Like I said, I feel like you're just in your zone, okay? You're in your zone, and you don't want to be taken out of it. So pay close attention to those people that want to kind of take you off course. Like, if you already had a plan in place, and they're like, hey, let's do this, let's go here, let's spend that, let's spend this much, and you're like, no, hold on, Tiger. Like, no, we should not do that. I have to budget. Like, no, I need this. Like, no, if that's what you want to do, you do it, but I'm holding on mine. Like, you know, I just see you like, nope. No thank you, I don't want to go. Nope, I got it, right? So I just see you doing that, Capricorn, and in a way it's the funniest thing ever, because I can really, really imagine you saying nope, sorry, go ask somebody else. Like, no, and you're right to feel that way, Capricorn, because a lot of you have been going through so much for so long that now that you actually really do have victory in your home and you're like, yay, no, I don't want you to take this from me. I need this happiness. Like, you don't want nobody to take it from you. And you feel like no matter what somebody say, you know them so well. You feel like you know that they're going to try to take you off track. And the crazy part is, Capricorn, I feel like your energy is a lot more clear and a lot more happier this season. For the past few months, it hasn't been that way. It's been like up and down, kind of rocky, very touchy, very emotional. But this week, the first week of July, that new moon in Cancer is going to make you feel like, yes, I'm ready to invest. Where's my projects? Let me get on with my new business. Where, you know, I just see a lot of you possibly even getting some promotions, getting a raise of some sort. But you guys are going to be really, really happy for the most part. Even if something is in the back of your mind and you're thinking about it and analyzing a situation, the universe don't want you to be so passive, because you have this energy about you that can be really, really passive when it comes to strategizing and planning and processing. You like to just, it's not that you're being negative, but you just have an outlook that is very passive, and you're like, but what if this can happen? What if that happens? The universe don't want you to focus so much on what can't happen. The universe wants you to just relax, breathe, even if something is reminding you of the past, and okay, just relax and breathe, because the thing is, even with the Cancer energy hanging around with that new moon, Cancer energy alone makes us feel like we're reminiscing, or something old from the past may return, or somebody, an ex-lover may return to you or try to call you up and try to work things out with you, okay? Someone is deeply probably even missing you and wanting you, and I feel like you're like, nope, I'm good where I'm at, I'm happy, I'm good. Like, I just see you just doing, again, you're like protecting your value. You're protecting yourself from something. And it doesn't mean that this person is bad or that is negative, but I just feel like you want to contain, or you just want to keep what you got. You want to keep that happiness. And you don't want nobody messing that up for you. But you are heading to a place where there's definitely a lot of happiness and contentment. And you're definitely going to get what you want this season, Capricorn. But go outside, have some fun. Don't overstress yourself. Again, don't allow someone to make you do something that you don't want to do. But I do see endings and beginnings here, my love. So there's an end to something. And for a lot of you, there's definitely a beginning. Or it might even be both. You might be walking out of something to only walk into something better. Or you literally may be putting a stop to something. And again, that may be the whole, no more. You're not taking this from me, right? And it's that feeling, because Cancers are very protective, and so are you. So I can only imagine that the whole month of July, you're going to be like, okay, I can have fun, but I still want to protect my finances. I can have fun, but I still want to protect my home. I still want to protect my children. I still want to protect my health. Like, I want to do this, but I have things that means a lot to me, and I want to protect it. And I feel like you're doing that a lot this season, Capricorn. You're like, nope. You can't take this from me. This is mine. This was given to me. It's mine. And I'm going to take care of it because God gave it to me. I'm going to cherish it. Like, I just see you really, really protecting something. Okay? And this could even very well be a secret, too. Maybe you don't want nobody putting your business out there. This could be a secret, too. Okay? But Capricorn, you are like Mother Earth, okay? You are literally the last the earth signs, but you are very, very serious by nature. But sometimes, man, when somebody is trying to take you, of course, I just keep saying that because I feel like you already have this plan in place. Like, you know exactly what you want to do, what you want to wear, where you're going, what time you're going to go, what train you're going to catch, what, you know, like, you already have things in place. And this person comes along all impulsive and crazy, and you're like, wait a minute, chill, I got this. Like, I got this. Okay, so the old must be released so that the new can come in, Capricorn. The new can enter, and it is going to enter. New aspirations, new projects, a new home, a new, you know, just something new. I just keep hearing new for you, okay? So this is definitely a season of transformation for you, but only if you allow it, Capricorn. And don't be afraid. Look, the universe is clearly telling you here to go outside, okay? Open up that solar plexus, that gut feeling, okay? Be very, very mindful and receptive again. So even if you have this plan in place and you have that gut feeling that's saying, nope, something isn't right, don't do it. If something is saying, no, don't spend all this money, then don't do it. If it's saying, hey, don't go over there right now, then don't go. Really, really pay attention to your intuition this season, okay? Because your solar plexus is really, really loud, okay? Your solar plexus is really loud right now. I see a lot of yellow for you. That's why I told you to wear yellow, okay? So, yes, you are Mother Earth, my love. So try to go outside, get in touch with the community. You may feel like, you know what, since I'm not working right now, let me do some volunteering, let me help out in the community, let me do give back to the community, let me reach out to people who I haven't seen in a while, let me go visit some people. I just want you to relax this season, Capricorn, because I feel like you earned it. Like, you've been going through so many things that you literally earned it to just walk outside and just do nothing. To just be happy, to just go to the beach and just kick your feet up and just relax. Like, you deserve that, Capricorn, okay? And so don't let nobody make you feel guilty for just wanting some me time, okay? You are not wrong for wanting your me time, okay? So, Capricorn, I love you. This is beautiful. I love your energy this season, okay? July 2nd, new moon in Cancer. July 7th or 8th, give or take a day, the Mercury will go retrograde until July 31st. However, Capricorn, anything serious by nature, like a contract or anything of sort, try your best to not sign it just yet, okay? Unless it's absolutely necessary. If it's like life or death, or, you know, if it's something extremely important and you have to sign that contract, then just make sure you read it. And I don't really feel like I have to give you that speech because, as professional as you normally are, I'm sure nobody won't be able to get nothing past you anyway. So that is why your solar plexus is screaming loud and clear. Like, pay attention to me. Pay attention to me. Your intuition is speaking to you. Having dreams, those epiphanies, pay attention to it. Make sure to wear a lot of bright colors this season. It will raise your vibration naturally. It's impossible to look at yellow and get depressed. So wear yellow, okay? You look beautiful in yellow. Wear yellow, okay? Wear yellow. Yellow, yellow, or white, or something really, really bright to just, like, make you happy, okay? But yes, endings and new beginnings. This is exciting, Capricorn. I can't wait to see you in August. Please comment below and let me know how you guys feel about all of this energy. And also, July 8th, we have Venus going into Cancer too. So again, this is going to open up the doors a lot when it comes to love, you and your spouse having a lot of communication about your finances or your new home or your new car, whatever it is. Pay attention to new investments as well, okay? Make sure that you, again, just read everything. If something don't make sense, 9 out of 10, it's probably BS, but go double check. That's all I'm saying, all right? So I love you, Capricorn. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Comment below. Love and light, always. Keep it sweet. And I will see you guys next month. Oh my God, I cannot wait to see what you guys did with all this beautiful energy. Love you. Bye.